How has the FS exam changed in 2021? Or has it? I can tell you, beyond a shadow of a doubt, it has changed. And it's changed for the better. Years ago, when I took my FS, it was a good mix of surveying, engineering, computer science. It was a tough exam, but it was fair. Over all of these years, it's really evolved into what I thought was an overrated math exam. Bogus, bogus, bogus. But as of 2020, 2021, the FS has made another shift in systems and questions and categories. And this time, it's a great one. Hooray! I think that over the years, mathematicians, eggheads, somehow at least partially took over this exam. And as of this year, last year, the FS exam has really shifted less toward mathematics, like pure math, and more towards surveying and surveying math. So we're coming back to our roots, folks. We're coming back to our roots. This is good news for everybody. Now, I'm not going to tell you the exam is easy, because it's not. But I have, under good authority, that the FS exam has gotten easier. And that is because of the focus less on linear algebra, differential integral calculus, differential equations. The FS is really moving away from those just purely math questions. And it's trying to at least put those questions in as surveying math, something you and I can relate to. So how do you, shift your study habits? Well, if it was a year or 2 years ago, I would say you better know the matrix determinant, the matrix inverse, the matrix transposition, all those things. Now, those still could be questions, but not nearly as much as they used to. So, if you want to use your time wisely studying for the fundamentals of surveying exam, you need to remember that the morning session is predominantly surveying math, and the afternoon session is mostly like legal aspects, standards and specifications, all that good stuff. So, study habits have changed from pure math to surveying math. What do I mean by that? Well, traversing, coordinate geometry, volumes, area, all those good things. And don't forget trigonometry. Trig is a huge part of the FS. They're going to ask you surveying sort of related trig questions. So don't forget SOHCAHTOA. And remember, how do you use angles, distances, how do you form triangles, all that good stuff. Now, the last suggestion I have for you in terms of surveying math. Strike me down for saying this, but if you do not have a pre-programmed calculator, you are going to be in desperate straits for time. The FS exam is 6 hours. It goes by so quickly. So I highly recommend having a pre-programmed calculator. So if you can see a triangle and know what angles and distances, like what is X, what is Y, then put it in the calculator, let your HP solve it for you, and move on quickly. Because the more time you save on the computation questions, the extra time you have on the tough questions, they're going to set you apart from everybody else. So don't waste your time with the little Casio calculator solving a problem. Use this calculator to your advantage, and then you can go ahead and use your time more wisely. So to sum things up, the FS exam now has fewer theoretical and pure math questions, and because of that, it's a great thing. So give the NCEES two thumbs up. Tell them thank you for, re-engineering the FS more toward surveying, less toward, you know, egghead math, and let's get studying, guys, because I'm just excited as you are to get your exam passed.